Thank you for my introduction. Today's topic is a very good topic, and it's close to our heart. Whatever my speakers who were speaking before me have spoken, I really appreciate their thoughts, their vision, and that is what we all need to look at. Amit has given a very good video presentation of Gandhinagar, where he talked about the smart city being created and whatever we have done over there. You know, when we see these type of video, you really feel motivated. Yes, this is what we need to do across our country. But I think the first thought which should come to our mind is that out of deploying these smart cities, let's say Gandhinagar became a smart city, what is the Indian content in this smart city? How much is the product or services which we have deployed in this city are produced here in India with value addition? I think being one of the fastest growing economy worldwide, 1.25 billion people worldwide, which is 17% of the global population, I think it is our responsibility to produce our own industry, manufacture these products here in India with value addition, and deploy them across India and then export it worldwide. But I feel really sad when I really think about this and when I see the ground reality, what are happening across. My earlier speaker, Dinesh and Mr. Cloud, they talked about standardizations. I very well appreciate what they really are talking about, what they're all viewing. Our respected AST is here in the hall. We are blessed by his presence. I would like to take you back a few months back, where there was a huge talk, huge debate, which was happening across industry about BharatNet. When BharatNet was being conceptualized, there was a lot of discussion, a lot of debate across vendors, across service providers, that what should be the standards for this BharatNet. Someone gave his own vision, second person gave his second vision, third gave his third vision, and it was all confusion prevailing across. One thing which DOT, our parent ministry, did very good at that point of time, they basically installed a committee report saying that in our country, these are our requirements, and this is what we need from technology and products to really be there to come out as BharatNet. And this is the way we will really grow. It also gives me a reminder, sometime back when Indian Railways, they were coming out with requirement of optic, putting fiber optic across their tracks, which was one of the very critical requirement for signaling and communication. There were a whole lot of standards which were being talked about. They came out with the requirement where TEC helped them, saying that we have stations which are far-flung, there is electricity problem, there is a lot of dust, there is a lot of noise, and we cannot provide very high-cost air-conditioned chambers to protect these equipment. The standardizations which came out, which was the requirement of our country, was that we need equipment which sustain heat, which can work at around 50-55 degrees, which can sustain a lot of vibrations because our platforms are not that highly developed, and which can work without air conditioning. And today, believe me, whole of our country runs on products which are designed, developed, and manufactured in India, suiting that requirements, and these products are being exported worldwide to all developing countries. I think as a community of people who can really think smart, we all need to think at this point of time, what is that which we want from these smart cities as a country whole? Do we want just foreign products being deployed across, or do we want to do some value addition where we create our own standards? And though I'm not saying that we do greenfield research, standards exist worldwide, but what is that which is best for India? So one of my suggestions from this presentation is that we need to have some committee formed under government support, under Ministry of Urban Development, DOT, DIT, so that we come out with standards for our country. This is first. Second point, which I want to again harp very strongly, For last many years, we have been listening Make in India. And this is becoming a buzzword, and everyone wants to just think of Make in India. But where is the reality? Today, if I look at smart cities requirements which are coming up, as per our mandate, there are some 109 cities which have to become smart city very soon. Out of which, I think 10 or 12 have already gone ahead with tenders. There are requirements which have been floated, and some of them have concluded their tenders. But again, I want to pause here and want all of you to think. Whatever these 10 smart cities have done, or whatever standards or tenders which have come out in these requirements, are we doing the right thing? Are we promoting Make in India? There is a very good policy which Government of India has come out with, which is called Preferred Market Access. Preferred Market Access policy very clearly says that any spend which Government of India does for its own use, that has to support domestic manufacturers with value addition. Is PMA a standard policy for these smart city requirements? The answer to this question today is no. When we go and talk to authorities who are doing these smart city tenders, to our surprise that these are the municipalities who are doing the tenders, who don't have any wherewithal about what needs to be bought, how these smart cities will be deployed. This is the practical reality. They rely on consultants, and consultants drive whatever are they accustomed to. And so PMA, even after pushing lot and lot with authorities across smart cities, we as Indian industry, as domestic industry, we have still failed to ensure that this condition becomes mandatory in all these requirements. Point number three, which I also want you to think, and we need to really do an exercise that how do we get in there. Today, if I see across whatever is required as components and as products, as technologies in smart cities, everything is being manufactured here in India in huge number. Like our company is based out of Bangalore, and we see so many startups which have come up, which are developing beautiful products and technologies which are not existing worldwide. But when these requirements are being floated, when these requirements are coming up, what is being asked is that the companies who are allowed to bid in these tenders should be in Gartner's magic quadrant, should be in the top five of IDC worldwide report, business analysis. We need to again think and look at this. When we are talking of Make in India, when we are talking of PMA, when we are talking of Smart Startup India, are we supporting our companies? Are we supporting our youngsters to be part of these smart city requirements? Are we nurturing them? Again, the answer is no. Point number four, which I also want to highlight. Today's requirement of smart cities, which are coming up, they are asking for certifications. We have been buying products in India for ages now, since independence. Till date, we have seen all the tenders coming with certification requirements of India, which could be TC certification, which could be STQC certification, which could be BIS certification, or something which is here, which could be QA or anything. Whereas, very, very surprisingly, the requirements which are coming up in smart cities, they are asking for certifications which are foreign certifications. They are clearly saying no to Indian certification. If a vendor or a product developer or a manufacturer in India, he has an Indian certification, which is exactly what they want, smart cities are showing them gate to please go outside. We don't want certification which is Indian. We want certification which is foreign. Why? Don't we have our own certifying agencies? We have standards. We have TEC, which has built all these standards. Why can't we accept their certification? So my request to all of you, it's a group of thinkers, leaders, policymakers, we all need to really get together. We need to ensure that we request our government, we request our smart city executors that please support Indian organizations ensure that you ask for Indian certifications. Please ask for Indian specifications which are suited to our requirement. We are not saying that we should not buy anything from outside. It should be a balanced mix where both Indian and foreign organizations are competing together and really eyeing for a good growth. It should not be a door shut for domestic companies, which is our first responsibility. Thank you very much.